टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर टुडे वी विल फिनिश द चैप्टर ओके ऑन द टॉपिक चेंजेस अराउंड अस लेसन 7 पेज नंबर 72 टू 74 वी विल रीड एंड डिस्कस ओके नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस पेज नंबर 72 73 एंड 74 ओनली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ changes in solution, change physical change and chemical change. Then to the next classes we will discuss their question and answer. So at first you will read the whole chapter very carefully. Then you will have to solve the question and answer very carefully. Now everybody open your book page number 72, 73 and 74. Page number 72. At first, you know in the previous classes I have discussed already various kinds of changes in our environment. Mainly, today we will discuss topic solution. What is called solution? Solution means solvent plus solute. Okay. Solution, that means mixture of any solvent with the solute. Solute is not this. Solvent is this. Solvent means always water. That means H2O. Okay. Solute. Various kinds of solutes, salt, sugar, okay, mainly salt, sugar, glucose, sucrose, there are so many examples of solvent, a solute, that means the substances that mixed with the solvent can make solution, okay. For example, if you take some teaspoon of sugar and add it with a glass of water, after some time you will find the solute, that means the salt and sugar will be soluble in the water. Why it is possible? That means the characteristic features or the chemical features of the solute is just like that. That means within the water and the solute solvent, the solute soluble with the various kinds of substances. This is the characteristic features of various kinds of substances which solute to the solvent. Okay. That means sugar plus water makes sugar. And sometimes we need some heat. Suppose the quantity of the solute amount of high amount are taken high amount. So solute do not want to mix with the solvent. So you will use so many heat. After the heat, after sometimes 2 or 3 minutes, then we gradually the solute will be dissolved in the water. When you make tea in the kitchen, you look this type of changes. Okay. Now in this universe, there are so many changes. Changes are two types: reversible changes and irreversible changes. Changes are two types: reversible changes and irreversible changes. When you will see a child gradually increased, that means they are shapes and sizes of the body will be gradually increased. That means, and do know what? When he born and gradually it increases their bodies and make or transform into an adult man, the adult man do not return to the child. That means this type of change is called irreversible changes. Okay, this type of changes is called irreversible changes. Breaking of chapati, that means flow meet with the water and make chapati. Chapati do not make the baking of flow. This type of changes is irreversible. There are so many type of changes are found. These are called irreversible. That means one way changes. When we will make from one step to another step, they do not change. Reversible. This type of changes is called. When you will see when fruits are ripened, fruits will ripe. The ripe fruit do not change into green fruit. Okay, this type of changes is called irreversible changes. And so many changes which I have given the examples. Solution, that means solute plus solvent, that means sugar plus water. Sugar water solution. Then you will apply the heat. Okay. Then sugar and water will be separated. So this type of changes is called reversible changes. Next, physical changes and chemical changes. Physical changes. In the another hand, the changes are different. Physical and chemical changes. Physical and chemical changes. Physical changes. That means when you add two substances and make a new substances, and the new substances will return to the primary substances. Free apart. Okay? This type of changes is called physical changes. That means in this change, the temporary change. Physical change means temporary change. New substances form, but generally it returns to the primary state. So a physical change is a temporary change in which no new substances are formed. But in case of chemical changes, for example, when you burn the coal, when you burn the wood or the coal will be changed into carbon dust. The carbon dust will do not change into coal or wood. So this type of changes is called chemical changes. So the chemical changes and physical changes mainly. Physical changes means the temporary changes. That means their physical properties can be changed. But in case of chemical changes, their chemical properties will be changed. Next, there are so many changes. For example, I am seeing ice. Ice is changed into water by the process of melting. Okay, the water will change into ice by freezing. Next, water change into vapor. That means evaporation, and vapor will be changed into water. This is called condensation. So these terms you will always mind in your memory. The term melting, freezing, evaporation, condensation, crystallization, sublimation. Okay. Next, chemical changes. When you make curd from the milk, the curd do not change into milk. So this type of changes is called chemical changes. Okay. Now, today, page number 7 to 72. Only reading the chapter, only 72 and 74, and the remaining parts of the previous chapter, previous topics, you will together revise the whole chapter, and to the next classes.